swimming, becoming a diving plan. Okay. With the advent of T20s, do you feel the bowlers are going a little flatter, not as little now?
See, I have a different take on this. It's only the limited bowlers. Those who won't have enough skill to resort to. Those who are already skillful, I don't think are giving any lesser revolution to the world. You look at the relevance of external achievement. It's the old axiom coming back again. Unless you don't give reps on the ball, you're not going to be a skill. So those of them who don't have much control or faith in that, they are the ones who will be pushing the ball through. So I don't think that there's a major shift in terms of the spinners are playing T20 cricket.
Yeah.
The numbers that went on to play, for example, any side that you had, you take any good state side, you have 3 to 4 good spinners in every club side. And a state has about 7 to 8 spinners to push. We don't have those anymore. So that's a larger question to address. But if you look at the best who have played then, the best who are playing now.
Why is it that then in India we're finding shorter leg spinners, actually South Indian teams, they are traveling with two left arm spinners. Not that they don't take the ball away, yes they do, but they left arm spinners, off spinners, maybe.
I think there has been a resurgence. We're getting a few. See, I would consider Kuldeep two over.
And
there is
at the end of 6th over, Alaa Khan 74
with 3 distances.
Not given a fair run is what I
know. If you look at the number of people bowling
next,
I think
the target for Alaa 50 is 60.
See, this is cyclical. I can't really pinpoint to say that. This is
the next full match between Vidya Mandir and Kiran Gopal Adaram.
Not traveling with an extra. Whereas Australia has an ex-spinner in Zampa, South Africa has. Our team seems to be going up.
On that. I won't say. Indian team, if you look at it, the reason is because the two spinners that we are carrying, they have been literally winning games for India. Like, you know, so obviously you will carry them. So that gap between Australia and Jadeja and the others is so big that we don't say, we tend not to see.
But the target for Vijay Mandir is 32.
Playing for India. It's time that he plays for the Indian team, and I have seen. And if you look at it down the line, since I watched the junior talent, what I see is a lot of leg spinners. So maybe in years to come, you will get, and I think it's like that, you will get these players in the world. We'll be reckoning at the highest level.
Next question is with regard to batting. Recently, I mean, as much as we don't talk technique and all to the younger junior, under 15, 19 cricketers who are coming, a lot of them, I'm just seeing both in the women's category and the men's category, doing predominantly bottom-handed because of the form of game, even women's cricket, because there's now the intentional sign in that cricket. But that has resulted in a very, very good. So how much is coaches, do they have a role in correcting this part of the head? Do we correct it or we say, no, go ahead with it, adjust and play?
Good question. What do you mean correction? I don't know what the issue with this. Both the hands must work
together.
It just means that you've got to strengthen your top hand.
I mean, what you're saying is that's exactly how we want to go about it. Like the fact that they are holding on to their bottom hand because they are light. Like, you know, men who are reasonably good top hand, very strong, even men. Why is there so much? Is this something that should be a concern, especially when the kids get slow? Once the season goes, wouldn't that become a very difficult thing and then
I'll give you an example. As a rule, all coaches need to ensure that everybody follows the basics. Where your top hand should go, where your bottom should be. Ensure they do that. But we will always find that in any coaching, in any field that we do, there will be exceptions. I'll give you one exception today who is the best in the world. Look at Steve Smith. He's got a full grip. Bottom hand is here, but the top is here. If your bottom is here, the top normally opens. Here is a guy who is unusual. But what you need to see is how much control has he got in drive. If the guy is able to drive with control, why would he change it?
So what's happening is people are taking fast to places. Steve is an example. And that's how the trend is going. I mean, there are
Listen, you only have to look at control. It's great to, in fact, I would always look at minds that look at the other side of it, not what you normally. It's a different mind. He wants to look at how they innovate. Mind. It lies in the execution. If anybody who has them as role model executes it as well as them, which means what? Which means you don't play, you have control over your pride. But if the particular student or any cricketer is having a problem controlling it, that's where we come in and say, try it out.
Do you think there's too much cricket happening in the school level?
I don't know about school level.
International,
I think too much.
No, because I think even school level, number of tournaments, right? Because these kids play for clubs, they play for schools, then they go and play some division team.
Yeah,
overall, this obsession about the game.
My only, if at all I can take a devil's advocate here, I need them to play a little more normally. I see a lot of controversy. I wish they play one day games, 90 over games, 2 day games. Instead of, that's my only. So that's it.
Because I think probably they're burning out much earlier than what probably
a generation. Concentration. Not longer working. This is like this. You know, that's where you absorb most knowledge. If the knowledge given to them is only about skill and not about concentration, then the problem lies in adjusting the concentration span over longer periods. So what I'm saying is, you are playing that many T20 and water versions, if they play some two-day tournaments, because number of days
they that's
where I think we shouldn't be falling into that trap. The balance between a water format and the longer format should be made.
But nobody wants a sponsor of something that's going to be played over 4 days.
But I think they would. I mean,
this has become very commercial. This has become very... The money model has come into play. Like, nobody wants to
play. I don't think... I think it's about those custodians of the game ensuring the balance exists. So if you play those many T20 tournaments, it's a matter of cutting one tournament and playing a 2 day tournament. You play a 2 day tournament for the balance, then you play. So there are three products today. T20, T-overs and long overs. You have to prepare yourself for all three. But the base is always about enhanced concentration. So they don't do it that. All I'm saying is have a tournament. Have a tournament that you play 2 days. You play for the school level.